Hey everybody, this is GliderCat, and it's time to play. We are back in FortressCraft Evolve. Last episode, we did the big walkthrough of the entire fortress. Hope you guys enjoyed that, especially those of you who may be new to the series or kind of just jumping back in after having not watched a lot of episodes, kind of get you caught up to where we're at. I did a little bit of work in between episodes, just basically clearing out some mining shafts that I think we're going to need, clearing them out of ore. It takes a lot of time. But we've got some things to do this episode. The first thing I want to mention is our central power hub. Now, it lasted a lot longer, but it did actually get destroyed not too long ago. And I came up after that happened. And we're not seeing it here right now, but basically I had one of the missile turrets here with 100 missiles, and then all of my imbued, kind of the turret we've got set aside for imbued was at zero because it was being blocked. So we definitely need to reroute our missiles so that we've got turrets that are fed the lower level rockets, these guys, the basic missiles, and turrets that have a completely separate supply line of the plasma imbued missiles, so we can make sure we've always got a mix of both. That is on the list. The other thing that we started working on a couple episodes ago was mining crystal, and we decided to do that, I think, at level minus 210. And so we're going to work on that this episode. One thing I want to do first is we're going to need a place to store this crystal and that we're mining. And we may need to dig out a space. So here we are in level 30. This is all the routing. Let's go to level 40 and see if we can find a spot where we are going to store the crystal. I've kind of gotten to the crystal mining, you know, last. I've already got titanium and nickel and all that kind of stuff. So we're going to have to find a location. Maybe either at the end of this row here on my left, or if it makes sense, we could dump a new storage setup over here, like a storage array over on this side where we don't have to go quite as far. What I've got going here now is the fuel, and I've got refined liquid resin storage over there. Crystal is kind of a raw resource in the kind of the design that we've got going. It does belong on this other side. This side is kind of meant more for refined products, more complex products, not raw resources. It doesn't really matter, right? But let's stick with the theme. We'll try and find a spot towards the end of all this where we can store off some crystal. And again, I'm coming down to do this first just in case we need to place excavators. I've only got three work floor excavators on me. I should have gone up and gotten more, but that may be all we need. Let's see, where are we at? We're at storage for titanium. This must be nickel coming up. I don't have these ones labeled. This is nickel. Let's solve that problem. From storage is really redundant. I'm like sitting right here, but let's just put it there for now. And then this is going to be, okay, nickel ore 2 storage. Good. And then I guess I've got an excavator here that was working to free up space. This is a good spot for the crystal over here. Let's put down some more or install some more lights in this area so we can see what's going on. And I've kind of given up on having the lights perfectly placed. It would just take too much time to count them off. I got hundreds of lights across the fortress here. So I just kind of put them semi-organized. Put one underneath there. Try to keep them lined up a little, but again, they're not going to be perfect. Let's light this up and see what we need to do to expand a space out for a new storage array with, I'm actually going to move this light over. A new storage array for just the raw crystal. About there. Close enough. Looks good. We definitely want this space open, so I'm gonna move. Let's move this one down. Power is a little scant down here at level 42. So I've got lasers and things transmitting power, but they are really split and split and split again across a lot of these workflow excavators. But it's been a while since we've moved them around, so this should be okay. That little laser should connect here. I can just rotate it just for the visuals, and it should connect up. Boom. Feed that bottom one. These batteries are charged, so there is some power going here. Let's see. Or let's count off the footprint of the storage bay. We need to see how far apart these are from each other. Let's count this off here. 1, 2, 3, 4 to the belt. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and then another 4, right? So they're 20 spaces apart. There's 4. Let me get these on my selected on my toolbar so we can just quickly place it. That's 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 spaces in between, and then that's the corner. And then how wide are these? I think these are 15 wide. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, 15 wide. We're gonna have to do some digging. That's all right. We don't need to have this all placed. We're gonna try not to manually dig all this out. Let me just see if I can at least get a little bit of the footprint down here. 1. Hey, what? Let's not. It's enough to know that we need to drill this out. Let's set up another drill here. How about right here? We'll maybe actually leave that one there. Okay. That's going to allow us to kind of change directions. And I've got 3 on me. I probably could have gone a little bit further over. I definitely could have, but this is going to solve our immediate problem and free up space for the storage that we need, or the space that we need for the crystal storage array. So normal routine. You guys have seen me do this a million times. Maybe I should use these guys. Bear with me. An issue. All right, that's it. Should be good to go, and I'll put some lights over here too, maybe. Seems a little dark. There, maybe there. Well, over here. All right, while that's working, we have other things to do. I guess I probably need to put down, well, that turret I bet covers us. That one gonna, well, maybe not. Just barely. We'll leave it. All right, now we want to go over to the, down to level 210. But we want to do it. Actually, we want to go to, I think, level 20 and get the cargo lift set up. I think I've got that shaft cleared out of any ore, so we should have a clear path from level, I guess it's level 30 down to level 210. That should all be clear. Well, I need to put more teleporters on this floor. I don't have hardly any. I think I just have one here at the end of the path. So I'm going to run up to the hub, basically, and get stuff for the cargo lift. We need, where is that going to be? In here. No, it's, is it logistics? Cargo lift controller. Okay, we need 9 of these. Craft one. Crafting. We get 9, though. One. Crafting, 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 crafting. We have a cargo lift in storage, but I'm going to get another one because I think that cargo lift that I put in storage, I have a use for that. I think I have another shaft that's just ready to go. I just haven't hooked it up yet. That's like for gold or something. But we'll stay focused on crystal here. All right, I've got my cargo lift controller. I've got my basic cargo lift. We have the ability to get these improved cargo lifts, but we're not producing mine carts or ultimate upgrade modules yet. So we'll just stick with the basic one. There goes some rockets to defend the hub. We'll see how long we last. All right, now I probably should have just teleported from the hub, but we want to go to 30. Somewhere around 210, right there. That'll do. What is up with this? Something looks strange here. What is... this is really something different. Huh. This should be filled in here. I'm not sure why this looks like this. Maybe from some manual digging or something. It all comes in like this. Yeah, I'm not sure why that was all hollowed out. Anyway, I think that's how it's supposed to be. This here at 190, we were doing some temporary mining. It looks like I'm done with that. I can clear this out. We won't bother with that though right now. All right, let's find 210. Okay, right here. This is our guy. We're at level 30, and I'm just looking. Make sure I'm not missing something. No, yeah, this is where our cargo lift needs to go. We got all this copper kind of... a little bit in our way. So let's do it. We need to go 4 high. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we do our cargo lift here, I believe. Let's see if I've got that on my hotbar still. I don't see it unless I'm scrolling right by it. There it is. 2, 3. 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. We gotta remember to go up to level 20 and add some power to feed the cargo lift. All right, there's our cargo lift. In fact, let's do that now. Can I hop up? Let's poke a hole and go up and get that power routed down here, because we're going to need that for the rack rails to actually get installed. Boom. Here. Back at 210, so we just need laser energy transmitters. I think I've been going with 3. I probably don't need it, but we'll stick with that for now. Thermic generators. All of this is pretty cheap to build. And then storage hoppers. Boom, boom, boom. That gets us plenty of power for our cargo lift. Okay, those are humming along. There goes the power. Take the elevator back down here. Boom, close that up. And then we need to put... I'm going with like three hoppers. I'm going to put three hoppers up here and load them with rack rails. Boom, boom, boom. There's about a 90% chance it's going to get stuck on something. There'll be some little chunk in the way that I didn't clear out. There they go. We'll just wait and see. All right, so we've got that started. I typically throw the cargo lift itself in once it's once I know that it's clear. That's going to take a while. We've got storage laid out. We need to do routing. But let's go back down and see. In fact, we're just going to go down to 40 so I can just hop down. Let's go take a look and see how that workflow excavator's doing. We've got most of the mining itself set up already down at level minus 210. We can set up additional mines. And again, if you remember, we're not going with the transport tubes yet. We're trying to get by with just, let's take out some of these guys. Trying to get by with just the conveyor belts. We'll see if they totally seize up. But last time I was down there, I had three full hoppers of, what is this? I had that selected on my toolbar. We had three full hoppers of crystals, so the mining and the belt seem to be working at least a little bit. I'm gonna clear this out just a tad. At least near the bottom here. And let's see if we can build now. I'll collect up this rock so it's not in our way. All right, we said 15. Okay, that looks right to me, and then we can just eyeball from here. Something around there. For that, I hit it at the first try. And then over here. We can clear out some of this. We'll use excavators to do most of it, but we can at least get it started and get this footprint put down. See if that does it for us. There is that one, and we just need to come back. We'll guesstimate right there. Oh man, that's amazing. I actually hit it. Cool. All right, now we just need to build this across and do that. We're gonna need lights here, but we'll wait till things get built. Here's that. Okay, there's our storage. And now we need to set up the inputs and outputs. Let's get that started. Let's see, what do I want? I want this guy on my hotbar, and we go 1, 2, 3, 4 diagonal. Then that's a belt, and then that's our pillar. 4 on the diagonal, 1, 2, 3, 4, belt, and our pillar. Let's see if we can get this thing up. Man, I'm just hitting them surprisingly well this episode. Kind of shocked. I'm going to take out that little nugget of coal. I have to take out a bunch of other stuff. Boom. This is our output of stored crystal. I need a belt going up. Probably should have grabbed mass storage inputs and outputs when we were up by the hub, but we'll go get them. Back. Gonna be something like this. I don't think I've got extra mass storage stuff on the hotbar. Let's take a look. That's for the rooms. Yeah, there they are. 6 and 7. No, I don't have them. We can get those, and then I gotta wait for this to kind of clear out before we can do the belt that's gonna feed into storage. It'd be nice to, let's see if we can, be nice to get that, because then we can go up on the third floor and do our routing. It's probably right where this work floor excavator is, though. Probably right where we need to be. Let's, we can put a temporary light down here. It doesn't matter. And it's a little more visible. See if we can work this while we're down here. It's not too much digging. Just want to clear out the spot where we're going to put that pillar. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then our pillar goes here. So we can get to the spot on the hotbar, and then we'll just double check it again. 1, 2, 3, 4, space, and the pillar. So here's where our pillar needs to go all the way up. See if I can do that without destroying too much. I don't want to destroy. Already poked through too far, I think. Let's fill that. Boom. Up. My center mouse button, by the way, every time I click it, or most of the time when I click it, it scrolls. So it selects the item that I'm pointing at, and then it immediately scrolls on the hopper. So that's why I have a hard time with the center click with this particular mouse. All right, let's put the pillar down if we can. Taking a guess here. I hit it again. And this one's going to have a belt coming down to us. Oops, wrong key. Like to get at that. I can't quite reach where I want to. Yeah, I can put a light or something. Let's put a torch in here just so I can see it when we go up to level 30. Boom. And again, this is going to be a belt coming down into storage. Boom. Down. And then we do our kind of goofy thing. It's going to block our work floor excavator a little bit, but that's fine. We'll deal with it. Boom, 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 boom. This we turn to this way. And another belt. And we add our priority splitter. And we make sure that is facing like that. Then out the bottom is our priority output. When we place it like this. And we want our priority output to go all the way back up to whoever needs it. Whoever needs crystal, it'll immediately come and go back up. So we can put a sign on here. Rotate it a couple times. Sure. Not sure why these are rotating. I guess I'm just not placing them straight. Okay. It's me just turning off the ambient music with the Control M. Boom. All right, and then we need a belt. This is the lower priority output of this priority splitter. We send that out down. Down and then across this way. And we need to burrow out a little bit of this. This is where our input ports are going to be. Boom. There's my center click here with the scroll. There we go. All right, we need to feed into input ports, and I usually do that like this. I said we'll go get the input ports in a bit. U, and then we do just regular storage hoppers. We could do logistics, but why not grab a little extra storage and use these? And then this lower priority belt of incoming crystal needs to direct into storage since it's not immediately needed. Boom. All right, that is most of the storage array. Like I said, we have some stuff to clear out here. We'll let the excavators do their thing as much as they can, and then I can come by and clear out the rest. But we've got the footprint down. We need to do a couple things. We need to get our input outputs for the storage array, and then we need to go check on the rack rails for the mine shaft. Again, level 40, the power down here is, we need to rethink the power distribution. I literally have like one, there's like one pyrothermic generator in the whole place that's powering all of my work floor excavators down here on the level 40. So that needs to be improved, and then we obviously need to put more advanced teleporters down, right? So I don't have to walk 4 miles. I'm just hesitating to do that now because the teleporters take a ton of energy, and that's pretty much going to stop the workfloor excavator completely for a good long time if I place down an advanced teleporter right now. All right, what do we want to do first? Let's go check on the cargo lift, because if we have to reset it, if it did get stuck and we clear the whatever the obstacle is, then that takes time to kind of reset. Let's go do that. That's 3,200. I probably could have just climbed through the ceiling, but I was talking and not thinking about it. All right, here we are. How is this doing? Rail depth 150, waiting for resources. And I got 3 empty storage hoppers. That's actually a good sign. Let's put in some more rack rails. So far, no obstructions been encountered. And this thing only needs to go down, it's not gonna say 210 meters. It's gonna say, what, 180 meters. Okay, rail stay blocked at 183. Perfect. Because we're already at level 30 below. And then so to get to level 1 to get to level 210 is 180 down, and then this lift is 3 up from the ground, so that's where the 183 comes from that you see in the lower left. So we're in really perfect shape here. Let's grab these out of here. And I can steal these hoppers back. Maybe if I climb up there, I've got a better chance of retrieving them. We don't need those anymore. And we can install the lift itself. That's this guy. We'll just drop it in. Boom. And it should immediately start going down to go get us some crystal. See, there it goes. All right, so we got to go get the input and output ports for our storage array, and then we need to come back and route the crystal somewhere on one of these belts. It needs to be the last one. This one's doing lithium. Let's see, where are my other belts? Just take a look. This is what? I'm gonna have to put signs on these. Oh, nickel. This is nickel. What is this? These two. I can't tell just by looking. Just the color blindness thing is a problem. I can't tell what kind of ore that is unless it tells me. Sometimes it'll show up. flickered there for a second. Air blocked. I wish it just said what it was transporting. Let's go see. But basically, we need one of these aisles for one of these belts for Crystal. And I think it's going to be right next to this one, to be honest. That is, I can tell just by looking. Oh, I can't tell. That's the end of this whole row of filters. What is this filtering? This is meant to be nickel ore. What did I do? Did I skip nickel over here? Titanium. Gold. Crystal. Oh, I saved a spot for crystal. Duh. That's right. We've got a spot for crystal. It's right here. So let's run that belt while we're over here. And one of the reasons why it became a priority is because we've got our quarry digging. That thing's made some progress too. Nice. Our quarry digging, and when it hits crystal, it was going to jam up everything else. So that's kind of why crystal became a priority to work on right now. This is our belt on level. I don't know why I put that down. That's not what I want. This is our logistics belt for crystal. All the crystal that gets mined from below will come across this belt. Boom, so let's run it. We might have to move some things along the way. We'll see. Looks like we got a nice open path, though. And I've got 17,000 belts on me, so we should be in good shape if I don't back myself into a big pit and fall down 300 levels. And where does this have to stop? This line, I've already forgotten which one it is, but this one? Yeah, it's this one right here. Crystal, we can put a little line on it. We need to hook up to the storage, and it's probably right around here somewhere. Let's see. Oh no, it's going to be back this way. So we're going to have to do some burrowing to get to it. Which means moving these work floor excavators. Let's do that. We know we're going to have to move this anyway. Hey, there's my little light. So this is where I need to be. Not bad. That's going to work out perfect. I don't, we're in the clear for the most part. At least I can get to it. I'm going to move this excavator anyway. It's just something that needs to be done. So let's do it. Boom. Sure that power is going to reach. We may have to extend it. Looks like we do right here. And then I usually throw down a power storage block and a turret just to make sure we don't have problems with enemies coming to steal the power. I can't remember the name of that enemy. It's not the Minoc, it's the other one. That's that. We'll let that run, and then we need to connect up that belt with this. So we're gonna, this is gonna be a pillar that goes all the way up. And get rid of that light now. And let's get this in place somewhere around here. Man, I'm just on fire. This is going down into the. That belt's going to be coming towards us, and then we want to go down into storage. Right, so we can label this. Sometimes I go higher, sometimes lower. Let's just do it here. Crystal. Boom. The output is over here. We can build this up at least a little bit. We're not using this yet. We need to set up a factory to make crystal clocks and all that. But the first step is just getting it mined. So let's at least poke this thing out of the ground a little bit so we can tell where it is. Okay, easy peasy. That's done, and then now we gotta get back to running this belt of crystal so it makes its way into storage. Way back there, we're gonna have to... Oh, I already burrowed a hole. Look at that. Planned ahead some other time. Thank you, Glider Cat, in the past. Let's see if we're gonna run into problems. This guy's gonna be in my way. They might. That's kind of an unfortunate location, but we'll make do. We're going to do a little zigzag around this guy. This is the output from one of our mine shafts. This is kind of a little bit in our way, so that's all right. It's workable. We can make this work. Boom. And we're going to stay on top for the whole run here. Maybe even... Let's say maybe a little extra. That much extra. Let's leave room for one more column here. So that means something like that. Then I'm going to opt to do this routine here. Hopefully that works. It'd be nice if we had some crystal on the belt, right? We will soon. To verify that this is working, I'm going to fall into a hole here. Watch me do it. Okay, it comes down from wherever. And then makes its way in there. Okay, now we actually need to hook up the mine shaft to feed that belt we just put down. And that is... We're at level 210, where we're mining the... where we're mining the crystal. But we actually need to keep running this belt. This belt is going to branch. And now it's going to start heading this direction. For all of the mines that are going to feed it from over here. If that makes any sense. We got a bunch of mining shafts. And the first one we're setting up from crystal is actually over this way. We need to do that. Whoops. Kind of try to be careful when I'm deleting things around a bunch of other belts, because man, all you got to do is accidentally delete some section of belt like way out there and your whole supply of gold or whatever stops, and then you have to go try and find out where what little nugget of belt got accidentally deleted. All right, this is our look at that, a full load of crystal here. Let's clear out that was just kind of scaffolding. We've got room for three belts, or three storage containers. Let's put those down. We should see those fill up. Crystal. Nice. We're doing it. And now we just need to connect. We need to filter this, because this mine could eventually do more than just crystal. So we got to set up all our filters. And then hook the crystal one up to belt. That's, I think, this belt, right? It needs to keep coming back. Yeah, that's the one. Again, we're going to have to label these periodically. Just put signs across this whole belt array so I can keep track of what's what. Trying to reach this one. Let me zoom. Do I have it? I do. I need to have belt selected. I'm going to double check it. Just again, because if you have a gap, they can be hard to detect later on. Okay, that looks good. Looks connected. We want to bring this all the way back to that mine shaft. Meanwhile, down below, the workflow excavator should be clearing out the space above our storage array. I'm going to steal some coal here that I'm just mining to clear this deposit. Got a few of those, I think, right in this area. That may be as far as we need to come out. Let's do our filtering. I don't have a good sample nearby, do I? Way out here. I'm going to just double check. Pretty much know how I need to lay this out, but I'm just going to check this one. So we got our storage chest, then we got a belt, and then we start all the filtering. Storage chest, then belt. And we've been using logistics hoppers. We don't have to. We could use any hopper we want. Fortunately, this copper deposit's just out of our way. From here. You there. Belt. And then we start doing our filtering. Got a bunch of these to place. Fortunately, I've got a lot on me. This first one is coal. And then this one becomes everything but coal. Good. Next one is tin. Then we've got, I believe it's copper. Then I think it's iron. I may have to check. I think it's iron. I'm pretty sure, but I'm gonna check. Let's see, can we iron? Yep. Iron. What happened to my display? Oh, look at that. It's magically scrolled. That was strange. Double check this one. Everything except iron, good. That's what we want. Next, I think it's lithium, but I'm gonna have to check. I may not even have a filter set up for it over there, do I? Let's run this way and see. It's just important that these things are 100% correcto. Everything except lithium, yeah. So that's lithium is next. And I think it's gold and titanium, then nickel, but I'm gonna double check them all. Because that's just the way I am. Lithium ore. Boom. Oh no, crystal comes in here somewhere. Right. There could be an inconsistency. Where? This is our crystal, right? So we know that one's next. Crystal deposit, those are called. All right. Then what? We can actually, let's get the crystal going up there for now. It's gonna be something like here. Again, we don't have the storage all hooked up just yet, but we will soon. This needs to be a belt going up. Boom. Boom. There it goes. We are bringing up crystal from the depths. We need to shore up the mine. We have to scale this. There's a fair amount we still need to do. I can cheat and see what this is. I bet it's gold. Gold it is. Gold's next. Still have 25 filters, so we're in good shape there. Lore. Boom. Gold ore. Let's invert it. Boink. Then it's got to be titanium. Double check it, but not right the second. Pretty sure. By pretty sure, I mean like about 30% sure. Could be nickel. I don't think it is. Whoops. Make sure you invert it. We'll double check all those too. I think this is nickel. I think that's the last one. We'll double check this. And then everything that's not nickel, ooh, is garbage. So what is that? Is that a crystal that just made it through? Yeah. Okay, let's check real quick, make sure all of these ones going straight are the accept ones. So I'm just looking at the bottom left. There's an accept coal, accept tin, accept copper, accept iron, accept lithium, accept crystal. Okay, we're good to go. So in theory, nothing should end up in this this little spot here, this last hopper. We've got the crystal routed up. The mine's bringing it up from underground. In fact, that's the second trip there. It's being sent down the belt over to storage. We just need to finish hooking up the storage array. And we can verify maybe right here that this is the titanium belt next to the gold one. Let's just double check that. Pretty sure it's titanium and not nickel. Yeah, we're good there. And then the final belt looks like it's there. That is our nickel belt, I hope. Nope, that's titanium. Oh, that's the titanium. Is that where we just came from? This would be maybe the nickel. Here is the crystal. Oh, yeah, it's a little bit of a drag, right? The crystal storage is last. Where is nickel? Nickel might come before the titanium. Ugh. Hope I don't have these mixed up. Was that just three things that said titanium? A titanium to ore to storage. Is that really titanium on there? I think I may have a mix up here. That's titanium to storage. That should be titanium coming out. That says the titanium to storage. That says titanium to storage. And there's somewhere in here. It's probably this one has a sign. How does it even have a sign? Let's see if we can get to it. I see, I made a little hole. Titanium. Okay, one of these is actually nickel. Yeah, one of those. So it might. I'm not sure which one comes next. Let's go. We got to check. We got to solve this problem and then clean it up. Let's see which one is actually next. If it's titanium, then nickel, or nickel, then titanium. I can't tell by looking at the belt. I think I've got. Yeah, I think this is the nickel is last. Oh, man. I don't even have a belt set up for it. Let's. What do we got going on here? Gold. Crystal, then gold. This one doesn't even go out all the way. What am I doing? There's everything except titanium. I guess I just didn't bother. It doesn't make sense to put filters for, say, nickel on a mining shaft over here that's kind of not so deep. If nickel cannot even possibly be produced down at level 380, that's why those filters don't show up over here. Okay, so nickel is last. Gold, titanium, and then nickel, right? And this is our nickel line here. Let's follow this and then we'll see what storage this is going into, and then we can maybe fix that problem. And I gotta be careful deleting stuff or removing material over here. This is nickel. We're just gonna label the deposit, or label the belt that's going into storage to indicate that this is nickel and not titanium. That's this one. This should be nickel. I'll probably double check these off camera or something between episodes. I must have done this when I was a little tired. I think the titanium has a little bit of a blue tint, right? The ore? Oh man, we're running long already on this episode. Yep. Boom. All right, let's wrap it here. And then next episode, we will go fetch input output ports for our mass storage array on the crystal. Then I think we should go down to level minus 210 and shore up the actual mining. We're mining like one little pillar or something of crystal. We need to shore that up. We can move some excavators too. I've got some workflow excavators down there. Opened up level 210 quite a bit. Hopefully we can find some more deposits. The other thing we can do in between episodes before this one, I mentioned I was kind of digging out the mine shafts. These mine shafts, they do have ore in the way. The quarry we have placed is going to solve that problem for us. From now on, it's going to dig out the ore as well. And we'll get to use the ore. But some of these older mine shafts, most of them, have ore in the way that needs to be burrowed through. And between episodes, I cleared out level 220, I think, all the way down. And I cleared out level 230, I believe, all the way down. So we could set up some more crystal mines on these two levels. So that's another option if we want to shore up the crystal production. And then we can think about putting a factory down to produce at least the crystal clocks and get a supply of those. Not sure. We'll have to think about that. I'm not sure if I need a big, huge storage of those, or if I can get by with just having a few for kind of handcrafting, having a few hundred or something. So we'll see if we set up storage array for that or not. But either way, I think next episode we'll finish setting up the input output ports and shore up the existing crystal mine. So we've got a good supply coming in. For now, this is GliderCat saying thanks so much for watching. Hope you're enjoying this series on Fortress Craft Evolved. I'm enjoying putting it together. It's probably one of my favorite games on the channel right now. I'm really enjoying it. Hope you enjoyed the last episode where we went over the entire fortress, how it's currently laid out and what we're working on. And I'll see you all in the next episode.